Hey guys, it's me, Glenn M. Welcome to a new video. And what this video is about is I'll be showing you how you can play multiplayer on Ninja Kiwi's Flash games using these private servers I'm hosting. But getting started, you're just going to make sure you have the Ninja Kiwi archive. If you don't, just look it up on Steam or download it from the Ninja Kiwi website. So when we load this up, you know, as you can see, we can play any of these games. But if we try to, for example, use these multiplayer features or any of these other online features in the game, so they're just not going to work.
So you're going to want to click the link in the description for the GitHub repository and scroll down here to where it says releases and click this link. So it might show a different version number when you're watching this, but it doesn't really matter.
So it'll take you to this page here where there will be a bunch of files, and the one you're going to download is this one right here called flashclient.ps1. So we're going to download that real quick, and then we're going to go to our downloads folder, and we're going to right click on it and then click run with PowerShell. And it'll probably ask if you want to run it, so just click OK. Next, before we press enter, what we're going to want to do is we're going to want to close all Ninja Kiwi archive windows, and that includes this launcher here, so let's just do that real quick. And then when we go back here, you just press enter, and it's going to download something. And now that's done, we can just close it. So obviously, what you might be wondering is, well, what did it actually do? You know, actually pretty simple. What it's doing is it's just downloading one of these zip files from the release that we saw earlier, and then it's just going to extract it to this folder here, which is, I'm going to open it up real quick. As you can see, it just created these files here, and so this is a technique called cache injection, which is a really simple way to just bypass some of the restrictions that Ninja Kiwi would have when we try to load a modded Flash game. So the mods, you know, they change very little about the actual game other than the IP addresses for the servers that they're connecting to. Anyway, so I've just started BTD5 again, and right away we're going to see that all these special missions are here. You know, these are all the special missions for BTD5. They're looking pretty clean. We can play any of these.
So that's actually it. If you've made it this far, then you can use any of the features on screen. And next up, I'm just going to real quick show you how you can install this on a Mac device. And it's actually the exact same. But first, you just want to make sure that you downloaded the Ninja Kiwi archive from their website and not from Steam, because they actually don't support it on Steam. And then after that, it's just the same. You just get the exact same script and run it, as I'm going to show here. And also, if you don't want to get PowerShell, you can just install it manually by extracting the zip file. And there are instructions for that on the GitHub README.
So next up, you might be wondering, you know, it asked me to install Flash, but I don't have an admin account. Can I still play this? And the answer is yes. You just want to look this up, download this file, and then put it in this folder here, so app data, roaming, Ninja Kiwi archive, Flash, system, and also delete whatever was there previously. And then once it's here, it'll just magically work. Installing Flash Player, and we can verify the signature. So next up, I'm just going to show some of the quality of life and content stuff I've added, mainly in SAS4. See, you know, immediately that there's a bot here, and so we can add them like this or this, and then we can remove them with this command or this command. We can also remove all the bots, but as you can see, after we've removed all the bots, we can't use chat anymore, so we would have to rejoin if we want to use any more commands. And so what this means is that you can play a level 400 game without having to wait for multiple tabs to load, which is really convenient. I'll show you real quick, we can join this code here, code 400, that'll just make four of them instantly, so that's just pretty convenient, you know. And the bots just leave when building starts. There's a lot of these commands, actually, you know, obviously there's ones I just showed you like that, but we can also just get some, like, stats or other stuff about the game. This is related to the RNG system, it's just our pain. So next up is the events, and we can actually play any event we want on any day by using private match codes. So for instance, if we use code APOC, we can see here, there's an APOC lobby. If we type LMS, this is an LMS lobby. And we can also type samples for a virus sample swab. So you might notice this is actually a different bot, and this bot will stay in the game for 5 minutes and is specific to virus samples. That way you can play a solo game of virus samples. And there's another third type of bot which is going to leave in 5 seconds. And we're going to see how we can combine these to get like an actual playable virus samples game. Type this command map here, that'll change the map. And then when we start the game, you're going to notice right away that this is a contract map. This is not a virus samples map. And so I actually added these maps to the events, and you can play them in all the events. And we can also play Alpha Virus or whatever's left of it, at least. As you can see, it's pretty bad, you know. So like, we'll pick this up, like there's no timer and then there's no score. So it's pretty bad, but at least you can play it, I guess, or whatever. Anyways, so I'll include some of Pocket gameplay later in the video. Now moving on to SAS3. So this game is actually really weird. It's actually a lot more server-sided than their newer games. So a lot of the multiplayer functionality, like the spawn rates of mobs and the loot you get, isn't actually 100% replicated here. And when we play, you know, there's no bots in this lobby, but there's a start button. And that's actually because the bots wouldn't affect the difficulty, because the difficulty is actually based on the average level of the players and not the total level. I got this information by just looking at every YouTube video of this game. So we're playing Purge mode, like solo here. I'm probably gonna die because I don't have any premium gun. So finally, we can play Counter Snipe, but the notable thing here is that if you wait in queue long enough, a bot is gonna join the game. You and the enemy actually see yourself in the same position on the map. So it's actually kind of skill-based if you're playing against a real player. So next up, suppose you want to host this yourself or maybe add some stuff to it. So the first thing you're going to want to do is mod the game in order to change the IP addresses that's connecting to, which I'm not going to describe completely, but it basically looks like this. Next, you just want to clone the repository, so I'm just going to extract this real quick. And before I start this, I'm going to go and change a variable so you can actually see all the packets that's receiving. And after start it, we just run this batch file. And I'm going to join the game. And we can already see that there's some data here. I'm going to let a bot join it real quick. And then OP loadout. Now we're going to see that there's a lot of data here. And this is basically all the packets of the game. And yeah, that's basically it. That's how you host the server. That's about it for this video. I know it was a very different video than usual, but I still hope you enjoyed. You can join my Discord server. I didn't really want to have one in the past because there were enough Battles 2 servers, but I'm doing stuff other than Battles 2 now, so it's probably going to be a good place to get support with these mods and just other stuff, I guess. So to join it, the link is down below. Some trouble in this mountain.
session, because many fellows are here, my loves, and the one for all love, and the all for wisdom, any other kings. So we all do serve this high mountain, any time, any way. High enough for right, high enough for okay. Tenderly, it's a place, it's filled with great love forever. We are about to explode. I spent time for the great days. Nobody phones with happy life. It's a place, any other kind of genres. We are just only. If you were to some travel in this mountain. is gone. There is no other way to have some fun. Up into the sky, there is a lonely.